Ahoy, mateys, and welcome to Small Soldier. Allow me to take the helm and guide you through my build of the Trumpeter 1/200 scale HMS Hood. Let's go to the bridge and check it out. What's up, everyone? Hope you're all doing well. Let's take a look at the progression on the hood.
Hello again, and welcome back to Small Soldier and update number 4 for the HMS hood. As you can see, I've made substantial progress since the last update. A lot of progress has been made, a lot of mistakes have been made and fixed at the same time. Okay, I'm going to break it down now and we'll look at all the components and what's left to be done in a minute.
Here you can see I've removed all the sub-assemblies so you get an idea of how I've broken the components down. I'm not really sure how I'm going to approach this as far as painting goes, but I'm sure it'll be a lot easier doing it this way than to paint everything in place.
All right, here's all the individual components that'll hopefully make it easier for me to paint later on. Let's take a look at the individual pieces.
This is the way it stands as far as how I'll have to paint this thing. There will be some painting on the deck here. For the most part, it's pretty open, so I think I can mask and hand paint most of that. It's mostly gray and the deck color. And then individual parts, like these will be fairly simple. Just the tops are gray. This one's gonna present some more challenges just because I somehow have to get into there to do some painting. And under here, because this is all glued together, this whole section here. I just thought it would be easier to put it together than to try to put it together later. Maybe I'm wrong. We'll see, I guess, when I go to paint it. Here, I'll have to do some fancy brush work to get in and around in there to do some of the linoleum deck areas. Same thing here. These are removable. These guns are removable as well, I believe. I think I've just blue tacked those in. This is all one, so I'll have to do some brush work in there too. This section here, course, comes off. This section, these sections here come off, and these guns that are mounted here, they are just blue tacked in as well. Areas like this shouldn't be too bad to paint up because you don't see anything on the inside, although on the inside of the deck you'll see I've got some stair rails already glued in place, and hopefully that works out. I have had them break off a couple times already, which is a bit of a pain in the neck. Gain areas like this, you can see underneath there are handrails and staircases that are already glued in place, so some of that will have to get pre-painted as well before it gets glued together. I'm not really sure exactly how I'm going to do this when I get to the painting stage, but hopefully it won't be too bad. That is all the components broken down into painting sections. I've never really painted a ship before, so this could be really either a disaster or turn out really well. Hopefully it'll turn out really well in the end, but that will remain to be seen.
That's the kind of fighting spirit that I was talking about. Listen to that guy.
All right, I'll just go through what's left to do on this project and then we'll conclude the video.
All right, going through what I have left here to do on the ship. Just a few small assemblies here on this instruction page. And then we come to all the small lifeboats and motorboats. And I will more than likely be adding the pontos photo etch for those ships. And as you can see, it's quite a bit of work left to do on those. And from there, the instructions are showing mounting a lot of the stuff that's been built, which I won't be doing till the end anyway. Next are the main guns, the up launchers, and the pom-pom guns. And there's a lot of photo etch here that I can use out of the Trumpeter kit. I may use some of this here. I won't be doing all the extensive photo etch on the pom-pom guns. Probably use the barrels out of that. And then on the main gun assemblies, I'm not sure yet. I may use some of the photo etch here in the Ponto set as well, but it looks like they do provide you with a decent amount of photo etch for the guns out of the kit. And then it's just a matter of assembling all the guns up, handrails, and then the dreaded full deck handrails. That I'm a little nervous about because Never done it. And it could get ugly. So anyway, that is the full extent of what I have left to build. It doesn't seem like a lot. It's only 5 or 6 instruction pages left, but like I said, there's a lot of work to be done on other individual components yet.
That'll do it for this update. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hey, if you like what I'm doing here, please consider subscribing. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an episode. Like and share this video with someone in this great modeling community.
But most importantly of all, don't forget to
keep those brushes wet.